Welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to Latimore. And the song that we are going to react to is Straighten It Out. Let's straighten it out. It is our first time single take honest reaction, not heard this song before. This is what we like to do on Enoma. If you are here for the first time or you are not aware of the way things work on Enoma, what we like to do is mainly, first of all, we are a patron driven channel. The requests that are made to us are mainly done by patrons who are subscribed on our Patreon page, and then we react to the music that is requested by them. But it doesn't mean when a patron has requested to us that we are all going to be gaga over the music. We have to be honest, and all patrons know about it. All our subscribers and viewers who have been here for 15 days or more, they know about it, that we like to make honest videos. We do not mince our words when it comes to the review of the song, when it comes to our opinion, when it comes to expressing how we feel about the song, what we hear, whether it is lyrically, vocally or musically. All three are the parameters, and then other implications, if there are any, the social impact of a song, whether it is negative or positive, whether it's highly controversial when it comes to sentiments of religious people, etc. All of that we keep in mind while giving reactions to the music that we are requested. We are not just two ordinary people who just sit here and then talk everything good about the music that we listen to. That won't happen. That is not natural, and that won't happen.
We do that only if the song is that good.
If the song is great,
we definitely go overboard with our emotions and our reactions if we really love the song. As in the case with a song just before this by Keith Washington called Kissing You. You can see our reaction and you'll know exactly what we're talking about. Same happened in another genre, a song, cross-genre song of Extreme called Get the Funk Out. Same way. We do tend like to go overboard a bit off and on, but it's still always honest. It's still pure. It's from the heart. It's quite true, genuine. It's so unscripted. So in the moment, it's all about mindfulness here on Enoma. We believe in living in the now, working in the now, being in the now, and reacting in the now. Not about keeping ready-made scripts or doing research about the artist and song. It's all instantaneous, it's all spontaneous, it's all impromptu. No preparation.
Also, we have no biases, or we do not discriminate among artists. We don't see the color of the artist before we decide whether we like the song or not. It may be the case in real life in certain countries, but not here on our channel. It is a place for all kinds of music, and from anywhere in the world, also by any musician who we like.
Yeah.
That doesn't have to be we like in advance. Means if we like the song, we are all in for it.
That's well said. That's really important what you just said, Kirti. Let's get started. Latimore, let's straighten it out. And you can check out our Patreon page to know about our profile and about us. Link in the description box below.
The intro video shows you why we started this journey of reacting to music, how we go about it, and things like that.
Everybody's gotta straighten out something sometime. I don't care how old you are or how young you are. I don't care if you're married, single, divorced, engaged, or shacking. You gotta straighten out something every now and then. But I want you to think about all the times that you've heard somebody say, let's straighten it out. Think about it. And I guarantee you that most of the time, it was a man who said it.
Okay.
Now, the reason why I say that is, well, let's face it. Most of the time, it's a man who makes it crooked in the first place. We don't mean no harm. That's just the way we are. Sometimes we do have a tendency to sort of take it for granted, don't we? Always acting like we don't understand some things. But I believe a woman feels things deeper than a man. I don't care what nobody says. I believe a woman loves stronger than a man. You see, sometimes we just don't seem to understand. I know, because you see, I'm speaking from experience. 'Cause I came home one day and my woman was just going all around the house, not having very much to say. And I was kind of puzzled. I didn't know what to do. So I looked her straight in the eye and I said, "Sit yourself down, girl, and talk to me. And tell me what's on your mind. Don't you keep on telling me everything's okay. 'Cause if it wasn't, you wouldn't be crying. You've been tossing and turning in your sleep lately, baby. Sitting around pouting all day long. Now how the hell you expect me to understand when I don't even know what's wrong? Let's straighten it out. Covered your head, or didn't even say goodnight. If you're tired and you don't wanna be bothered, baby, just say the word and I'll leave you alone. Instead of laying there crying your eyes out, baby, you and me ought to be getting it on.
Wise song, wise music, the way it is created, wise words there, and a lot of substance in the song. You know, even though towards the end of the song, it got kind of little bit, you know, repeating the same lines again and again. But before that, a lot of clarity was already given about this entire issue, about the situation, starting from a broader subject and narrowing it down to the personal life. That is how beautifully it was done. I like the song is taking up the crucial topic of communication between two people. The importance of communication is highlighted so beautifully. He first started by saying it was more of a narration, and then he started singing when it came to his baby, when it came to his life partner, when it came to probably his wife. He started singing it out, but before that he was narrating how, you know, the people who say straighten it out is going to be mostly men. And the reason why, because he admitted they are the ones who make the more mistakes. They are the ones who do the wrong things in the first place to begin with. So they know the need to sort it out, work it out, let's do something about it. Because they know they have done some damage and it's time now, a course correction time, it's time to mend things for a change. And then comes to his bedroom, then comes to his house when he's dying, he's begging to talk to her to understand what the problem is. He's been noticing her, he's been seeing all the non-verbal indications, all the non-verbal communication that has been going on in the house for the past week or 5 days. What has been happening? He was very vigilant, very, very alert, very, very observant to know what is happening in the house, what is happening with her. But it is very important to express that. I like the way he expressed it in the song. I like the way it was sung, right emotions, you know, stressed at the right time, expressed at the right time. And it was very wisely done, the entire thing. I like the music being gentle, just playing along, the guitar playing along with him, and him saying all the things that he had to say through this kind of a song. It is a song that can help people. If not only, you know, elderly or mature couples, but also younger couples who face these kind of problems when it comes to actually speak their mind, when it comes to communicate better. Nobody is a mind reader. Even mothers who give birth to their own children, the babies, they are not mind readers. They cannot read the mind of a baby. They have to go by what signs, what signals are being given by the baby. And later on, of course, when they start communicating vocally. So nobody can be a mind reader, whether they are the ones who created you themselves. They need you to say it, you to speak it out in order to help you.
These are the four best words when it comes to a topic like that that was selected. Brilliant songwriting, a brilliant concept, a brilliant idea, so relevant, so true. Topics like these will always remain evergreen and timeless, because by its very essence, by its very nature, it's something that bothers couples around the world, no matter where we come from. There's always sometime the certain ups and downs in the relationship. And as Kirti said, when it comes to the communication, a communication gap or misunderstandings or non-verbal cues that kind of show that something is going haywire. Her turning her head, sleeping the other direction, not wanting to talk to him, it went on for a few nights. And all those signs are there. He just said those four magic words, let's straighten it out. And added the baby in there before and after it at times. Let's straighten it out, the magic words. His heart was in the right place. All he wants to do is communicate, straighten it out. Let's get things back on track. Let's not move backward and backward. Let it not break the relationship. Let it not be a problem for our relationship's future. Let's straighten it out right away. Brilliant songwriting, brilliantly narrated and sung. I liked it. It reminded me mildly of Barry White, as well as of speeches of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., including the most famous one, I Have a Dream. So I loved it. Check out our Patreon page to learn about Kirti and me. We have another song coming up very soon. We'll get to it right away.